something unintelligible. But even on intelligible, perceivable things, to create the clarity, to create about its futuristic expansion, to create about its surplus expansion, to create about its multifaceted and multidimensional expansion and contact to studies, for all of these things, apart from imperceptibility, Vedas are meant for 5 readings, so they are very much essential. And the concluding statement is, we have to possess a system, which I lamented in the previous auditorium lecture also, the same stage, in a different auditorium it may be, I have given that also. We must have something like the Sikshana, Prasikshana, Vikshana, Samikshana and Parikshana, these things are to be essential. Sikshana is, we must be having thorough knowledge in scriptures. Most of the astronomers and astrologers, they don't have thorough knowledge in scriptures at all. And interpretation, contemporary interpretation, evaluative interpretation, comparing interpretation with the modern developments, etc. So these things are very much essential. So that is number one, that Sikshana is not that. Second thing is Prasikshana, intensive training in astronomical practices. There are only two options, taking outer tools or inner tools. If you are taking outer tools, you have to design a lab. If you are taking the inner tools, then you must sit quietly and in a placid mode, in an inert mode, in a mode of self-tranquility and self-embedded space wherein you can realize the reflective transparent surprise of your own inner wonders or inner splendors of your realistic inherent etheric space, Chidakasha, you can realize within yourself. So that is very much essential. So Sikshana is proper education. There must be, from some other institute, there must be BSc Vedic Astronomy. It cannot be very much affiliated to the modern trend. You know that most of the people are anti-scientific, anti-theistic, anti-Brahmanic, anti-Sanskritic, and innumerable such words you can coin for these people. So unless you create a Nobel Prize, unless you create a very great prize like a Templeton Award for knowledge realization through spiritual means, unless you create a global awareness by doing something visibly, unless somebody from this school of thought emerges as a global torchbearer to the evolving and growing system of modern technical astronomy, somebody unless represents our system and creates an eye-opening session, it is not possible for a global acceptance or universal acceptance. For that, a different system should be established. It should have BSc MSc, that is in astronomy, that is Sikshana. Second thing is Prasikshana, Prasikshana. Prasikshana deals with Nityaradhana, the Naimitika Aradhana, Upasana and various other things that must be done to people without meditation and other exercises. You cannot realize these things. You have to take the shelter of modern tools then. Then there is no use for our traditional culture and traditional lineage at all, that is Prasikshana. And third thing is, the society should watch. There must be a watching group, what they are doing, and how to cull out the other evil practitioners or fake practitioners. That should be some sort of Samikshana that should be in the society. And that should be some system by which a person can get into the divine blessing. Dikshana is what we call here, the Anugraha of Acharya and Bhagavan. So unless a person, Yamaivesha Vipirunate Tena Rabhiha, Tasya Yadma Vipirunate Tanu Swam, Yetat Sarvam Janardana, so there is a Vishnu Sahasranamaskara. So unless, as it is revealed to Brahma and various other people out of divine mercy or shower of divine affliction, there should be also a possibility to get the divine sanction, to get the spotless immaculate knowledge, which is universally applicable, reliable, acceptable, adorable and relevant. For getting that knowledge, you have to go to the purpose. So, number one, to create a proper system of education. Number two, to create proper training. Number three, to have a proper watchdog methodology to see if the things are happening in the society, and also to curb out the unruly elements inside the society so that the genuinity and credibility, accountability of the system can be established inside. Number four, to create a common forum to take into intellectual, financial and executive resources for that. Number five, to eternally try for all of these things so that the fifth thing, that is the shower of God, will be God by which we can get the real inner realization. By that of this inner real realization, that is revelation, I think that we can get more opportunities to show, apart from our stage speeches, apart from our scriptures, apart from our writing, and apart from the discussions that are taking between only hand clappers and head nodders, it should go to the rational society, it could go to the scientific society, skeptic society, it should be given some sort of vimochana or emancipation from hand clappers and head in order. It should reach the antagonist in the society and once more our system and its status should be well preserved, well nourished. Once again, the dawn of the Bharatiya Vidya, our Harsha Parampara, should be restored. The continuous, tiring, sparing, no effort activities that are done by ISER is very much applauded. I wish, pray, and bless the institution and the leaders to get more vigor, color, grammar, and all other essentialities that should enrich and enable and empower them to do more in the society, creating wide awareness and wide reach in the society to establish mass awareness and mega transformation within the soonest decade possible. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.